This is another interesting replay sent to me by Avalon Freedom. He is going to be on the Avalon side, and his ally is Granitor. His opponents are Conqueror the Saint and Info on the enemy team. Alright, and it looks like this will be mixed avatars. I do see a Shogun 2 avatar over here. Follow Samurai. Okay, so they will have mostly guns and cav on his side. He does have 3 150s. One is a French Marine. The other two are Imperial Infantry. He does have Red Bear, White Bear behind them. He has a Spear Levy behind two Black Bears. And in the front, he does have decent Yariki. I don't think he used Practice Grounds because they do have 16 melee attack. I think he could have got that extra 2 melee attack if he brought Practice Grounds. But I think he brought the Retainers, I think he used the Retainers Flogging Officer, Bandit, Horse Bandit Thief, Shinobi Informer, the Ammo Retainer, and can't think of Shinobi, Bandit Thief, Ammo. I can't think of the rest, jeez. Flogging Officer, but I can't think of a fifth one that they might take. Depends. Let's see, his ally, actually I should keep pausing so I could show, this will really, it's like, the replay is really quick at first, but then it slows down near the end. Alright, his ally, Granitor, let's see, Red Bear looks like vanilla. United States Marines, 150, no surprise. Red Bear, Vermilion, Red Bear, White Bear, 150, Red Bear, and for Cav, he does have Yariki, 18 melee attack each. Oh, wait, one has 15 melee attack, the other has 21, and his general is a Kmenjin, nice. And it looks like Freedom, and there's my dog co-commentating again. And he does have a Gungeon, and let's see, I'm trying to speak louder so you don't hear the barking. I don't know if that's working. Irons, Conqueror, the Saint, he does have a Gungeon. Sweet. United States Marines, 150. Imperial Infantry, 150. Another one, 150. Same stats. Vermilion Bird Force, looks like it's vanilla, has some... that's all from the passive abilities from his general, and he does have some hidden units, so he does have two Vermilion Bird Force, that's all I could see for now. For Cav, he did bring Yariki, 22 melee attack, 22, okay, 4 Yariki with 22 melee attack. He just brought him with 6 upgrades, but didn't use Practice Grounds. Let's see, his ally brought a lot of Cav, and this is MMI Info, brought a rush build. No missile units whatsoever. He just brought a lot of melee units. Yariash, these are pretty much meat shields, but I mean, they're very expensive units. They do have a hold firm. I used to call them hold stand. Let's see, Naginata Samurai. Vanilla, really. And kind of useless units to bring. I would recommend Yari Sams, actually. That rapid advance really does... it really does help when you're facing guns, because if they try to run, just use that, rapid advance, and you'll catch up and demolish them in melee. Plus, you could fend off Cav attacks, which is kind of desperate moves that anybody would do. For Cav, he did bring Katana Cav, 1, 2, 3 Katana Cav. For Light Cav, he brought 3 Light Cav, and for Monk Cav, 1, 2, 3, okay, 3 of each. And for General, he does have a melee gen, nice. So that's pretty much 20 units that he could send into melee instead of like 19 or so. Really does help having an extra, you know, unit helping you in the melee combat, so melee gens are really useful for that, but people nowadays like to bring a Bogen. And he does have a Waco Raider, it looks like it's vanilla. Non-upgraded. Alright, so let's press play, or slow motion, then play. And yeah, he is just gonna rush forward. He should really be flanking. I mean, this would be the best time to send all that cav he has. The best time. I mean, they're all in column formations, they're on the move, they're on the prowl. And yes, he will not attack. That is a good move. Good cancel right there. Actually, it's a good move to not move at all, you could say. So, let's see. Conqueror, he is going to move up his 150s. He does have three of them, and so does his opponent. So, technically, they do have the advantage. And he did throw down the Bombardment ability from his Command Gen. He does have one more use of that ability left. I don't find it that useful anymore. I really don't. He is going to run away this unit just to avoid the Bombardment, but it's nowhere near. This isn't going to kill anything, but I just like to watch the explosions. You know, I'm like Michael Bay, so we're going to stand here for a little bit. Just watch the explosions. Boom, 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 boom! There we go. Now, he wanted to move up and start the skirmish fights with his 150s, but he wasn't going to win that. He is shooting through a forest, and sometimes your bullets really do hit the trees and all, so harmful collateral damage to nature, and yeah. These two units are just having a staring contest, not really doing nothing. He is, yeah, they already captured the workshop. Let's see, there is some units rushing. They're running up, these are knocking out the samurai, they run really slowly. And they will be, they're trying to go into melee, but I'm trying to look at the units there. Yeah, Red Bear and United States Marines. Red Bears are pretty decent. Actually, the Red Bears can actually do really well against them since they have 8 melee attack compared to their 9. And I gotta really slow down. There is gonna be a major catfight, just to tell y'all everything that's gonna happen. There's gonna be a major catfight over here, and there will be a major blob over here. I watched this beforehand just so I wouldn't miss anything in the replay, just so I could explain that to y'all. I'm gonna slow down for y'all, so if I miss anything, I promise I will explain it and go back to it later on. I'll watch this replay again if I miss anything major, but he is going to send a Jerry Ash. There are pretty much main shields, and he's just going to blob up his units against one target at a time. It's a good thing he has the space in between. He kept a second wave of units, and his ally Conqueror, he is using a lot of good teamwork with his ally. He is giving him cat support, but all of his guns are way over here. That's why having guns with melee with your ally isn't really a good idea, because you're really not as maneuverable or mobile to support, and you really need that support. So they're pretty much going to try and force their way through, break the guns, and just keep going down the line. Maybe try and split Granitor from his ally up by breaking their center, but what you really got to focus on is this cav fight here. I mean, he's outnumbered and outmatched. Granitor is sending 1, 2, 3, 4 cav units if you want to include his general. I mean, it's a command gen. It's really not, you know, melee based or nothing. Nothing really useful for melee. Can't even shoot. So I really wouldn't count that. But he does have a Red Bear supporting, but it's not really doing the amount of, doesn't have the amount of firepower that it really needs to take out 9 cav units. Or 10 or 11. Jeez, that's a lot of cav. So he really didn't actually click on Granitor's cav. He's just going to push on through, ignore them, and that will damage them on the run. They're down to 36 out of 60, and they're dropping really fast. There was another cav unit here that I was looking at. Yeah, they are dropping very fast, and these cav units aren't even clicking them. So this isn't the cav glitch movement thing. It's not that. They did fix that. But let's check out this melee blob here. He did... Where is it? Here we go. He dropped on the bombardment, so there should be a couple blasts around this. Not a really good one, though. It's going to be around this area and one over here. So I'm going to put the camera right here instead. Right here. Maybe we'll see a couple bodies go flying, but not a lot. See, oh, shoot. One right there, one right there. Oh! So yeah, this is going to be very devastating for this blob of units. It's just caused so much, caused them to waver. With all these guns shooting them from multiple angles, it's just too much. And he just brought his cav to help him in this little melee fight that they really didn't need. Really, all this cav really should have gone for the guns. That's all they should have done. Kept on flanking or something. I mean, trying to power your way through guns isn't really a good idea. You just want to keep on flanking. I mean, pull a Valkyrie if you want. If you haven't seen that replay that I posted before, the Valkyrie tactic, then try that out. It's better than nothing, trying to go down the center or nothing. But yeah, broke up all that melee, destroyed all that cav. Look at all the bodies, Jesus. It's a nice little picture here. All the bodies, all the guns. And they're just shooting at any survivors. They gotta run. Yeah. You guys deserve to rout. Go home. Have a beer when you get there. You deserve it. After running towards all these guns. Jeez. So all that's left is Conqueror's guns. That's all that's left for him. This was really good teamwork on both teams' part. Conqueror did support his ally with Cav. I mean, yeah. His ally. He gave him his Cav, but his guns were separated. So maybe if they... The Cav blob and the melee blob, if they controlled it in a better manner, they would have broke on through a lot better. Maybe if they focused on... I don't know, maybe if they focused on Freedom instead of Granitor, because he had better Cav than Freedom. It all depends. Anything can happen. But they will give... At first, I think they were expecting him to continue his attack, but I mean, with so little forces left, what can you expect? So they're going to give him the courtesy of counterattacking him. Most players don't give each other courtesies after such a huge engagement. So this is really good sportsmanship. I don't know if people notice these small things, but usually some teams just wait for you to continue your attack, even though you know you're going to lose if you continue to attack, so usually don't give you that courtesy. So that's really good sportsmanship on their part by attacking Conqueror after such an amazing attack. You don't see an engagement like that often. I like seeing engagements that are really... 50-50, you can't tell who's going to win. But that was a really nice change and a nice comeback on their part. You don't really think guns would stand a chance against 11 Cav units and a melee blob. Maybe if it was controlled and the decision-making to engage it would be a little bit... If it was a little bit better, then I think they would have came out on top. But tough luck. Let's see. He will try and retreat. He's going to try and kite with his 150s. He's a good player. He's gonna try and kite his 150s against the 125 range units. Really smart work there. And he's gonna keep his Vermilion Burforus in the front. So, actually, a really good choice, actually. I should start doing something like that. Usually I keep my Vermilion Burforus in the back to inspire my units, because this unit can inspire units with its radius. It has, like, an aura. Encourages nearby units if you see that text while I'm hovering over it. It encourages nearby units. It's really good with your melee, and yeah, really good. So they're going to continue their attack. They're just going to muscle their way through with all these guns they have left. They have a ton left. They could just do whatever. Click and watch. He's going to try and flank around with this general. There is a white bear infantry over here, full strength. So nothing really left to do. Suppression fire did go down. Got on a few of his units going. Yeah, he dropped down suppression fire, and so did he, and it's gonna get on each other's units. Yeah, nothing really major to commentate now. As I said at the beginning, it's quick, and then it gets kind of slow at the end. But you can see where the outcome is gonna be. You can tell that they will win. This was a GG on both their part, but I can't really tell if they dropped or not, but I'm going to speed it up and you'll be able to see for yourself. But you can see that they clearly won. They're just finishing off their forces, and the replay just pauses. Now, I don't know for sure. Freedom, when he sent me this replay, he didn't say that they dropped or anything, so I can't really... I don't like to say anything without proof or from... the submitter's words themselves. If they said they dropped, then I would believe them, I guess. But the replay says it all. I guess they dropped or something. Maybe this was on Matchmaker 2v2, and they just wanted to drop to protect their leaderboard rankings. I mean, who knows? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm right. GG, thank you for sending me this replay, and I hope you enjoyed.